the world graphical.
I add value through my products.
I am an animator.
I am a filmmaker. I develop trends.
I transform designs to reality.
I create environments.
I translate stories to furniture.
I design experiences.
I'm an immersive media designer.
I design mobility.
This is not only a design institute.
This is a design lab.
Join us in our design movement.
Hi. Hello, everyone. A warm welcome to everyone who have joined us from all over the world. Welcome to the sixth webinar of MIT ID Loni. And webinar series has been started to create awareness and share the learnings of the institute with a lot of aspiring students and also students who are already studying to know about how the courses and what are the courses. So that's how we kind of started these webinars. So welcome to this sixth edition. First of all, I would not say good morning, good evening to anyone because I don't know from where you have all joined, and I can see a lot of people already joined in. So let's have a very good day and have a great time. So what we do here is we are getting today's webinar, which is more focused on giving you an idea about the immersive design, immersive media design as a master's course, which has started last year. So it's a course which was started recently, and it's a 2 years master's course, and we will basically introduce the whole course across to you as we go through the webinar. My name is Yogesh. I run a design studio by the name Sarg Design Studio. My major work is into mobility experience design, and I also work in narrative experiences. And I'm on the advisory board of this course and also take few courses here as a visiting faculty. Joining me with here is Shakti Banerjee, and Shakti is actually the head of this entire course, and he was the person who was instrumental in initiating and starting this course. So I would really request Shakti to introduce himself of his vast experience that he has in industry and what actually led you to start this course.
Thanks, Yogesh. Hello, everyone. I am Shakti Banerjee. My background is from I did postgraduate from NID, and from National Institute of Design, I did communication design, and afterwards I joined in the industry with Times of India. I did project for India Today, and then I shifted to totally different field, which is visual effects, and I was actually going into a lot of things like channels, promo. I was with ETV when ETV launched, that time I was there. Afterwards, I also gone to Bombay with UTV. So in the whole journey, actually the whole, I was kept on trying something new, as I say, and I also try to explore myself. And in fact, in my journey also, it happens that I worked with print, I worked with film, I worked on the video, as well as I worked on the internet, as well as I worked on advertisement. Wow. So what happened was, but what I feel the constant part was the narratives and the storytelling.
Yes.
And that is where I think the designer's roles comes to very important. And I have been into the technology also, because I have the I joined the channel also where I did virtual sets. Sakshi TV, they called me as a promo head, and I started doing virtual sets there.
Okay.
And that's the idea came into me that all this technology is there.
Yeah.
But what is the designer's role there?
Yeah.
And that is why I feel when I came into academics, actually, I came into academics in the sense where I can bridge the gap between industry and the academics, and especially for the students, because I feel it's very important to give them the industrial point of view.
True.
So I came into the academics, and then in a slow process, it happens that I came across into more more of technology oriented things.
Correct.
And eventually, this idea came to me as an immersive media design,
yeah.
Where you know, the things I previously, before immersive media, I was actually heading digital game design,
okay,
in NID.
Okay.
I was there for teaching there also. So I felt ki now this immersive kind of, you know, the technology is emerging.
Yeah, yeah.
It's very useful for the future, and the future,
yeah,
is totally. It's like we are surrounded by data.
Yeah.
We are surrounded with the technology,
yeah,
and the designer's role is such how to use that technology.
Mm.
So this program is evolved in that way that we are focusing on the technology, but we are focusing on the designer, how these students can use this technology,
yeah,
and they can do it in a much better way. And that's how we started this last 2018. We started this course.
That's brilliant.
Media.
Yeah, that's brilliant. So I've been a part of,
yeah,
this journey with you to some extent,
yeah,
as an advisory board member. So we know how it's been going. But I think one thing that's very clear and very prominent, that a person with his kind of an experience of industry coming into education is actually a very good thing that has to happen, and that actually helps the students to really keep their feet on the ground, saying, okay, we have a person who has done print, advertising, done a theater, or done various things, and I think that experience helps a lot. So what we will do today is, the whole webinar will be somewhere about 30-40 minutes. We will go through series of points which I will explain you as we go ahead. We will at the end take questions. So I can see there are a lot of people already joining, and I can see questions popping on the screen here. But hold your questions. There may be a possibility that a lot of questions of what you have might get answered while this session, the kind of informal chat we are having right now. And of course, that will go further, and you can put your questions and we'll pick those questions up ahead. So what we'll do is, Shakti, we'll keep this very informal, and I'm not trying to take an interview over here. Maybe some of the discussion that we are doing might provoke you, might help you to look at some exciting stuff. It might trigger, may help you connect some dots which you may not have connected before. But kind of let's go ahead. So what we'll do is, the whole webinar will be having these following points, and I think I'm just introducing this so that you get an idea. So we will first introduce, because Shakti keeps saying immersive hota kya hai. So we'll kind of go through that. Then we'll also look at technology, media, and what's beyond it. Not really getting trapped in the technology, but we have to see beyond it. Then we will also look at what is the program, what is the goal of the program. Yeah. So what do you want to intend,
yeah,
at the end? And one of the things that we have very categorically done for this webinar is we have curated some work out of the students' work,
yes,
which has been done at the institute, which will give everyone an idea of the kind of exploratory work that students are doing, and which is really exciting, and you will definitely be able to see those short videos, and that might also help you to find out, okay, these are the things that I can do. So those will explore you the various domains that we handle. And of course, at the end, one of the very critical questions, that do I have it in me? So can I become an immersive media designer? I don't know whether the industry really knows this terminology the way they understand a product designer or a graphic designer, but it's an evolving field. And probably, Shakti, am I right? This is possibly the first course started in India?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah?
Actually, in India, it is first time.
Yeah, so yeah, probably, maybe we'll make a lot of mistakes because we are treading the path for the first time. And
it's an evolving process. Obviously,
yeah,
we are evolving ourselves
and
also.
Correct. And we'll learn as
we'll
we go
learn
ahead
in the process.
So I think let's start with this particular introduction. I was earlier reading a book, and it was talking about the evolution of man.
Ah.
Yeah, and how communication and storytelling has actually made man where we are today. Yeah.
Yes.
Because we could believe in things which were not real. Yeah, I could show you a block of wood and say, this is powerful, and you believed in it. So there is a certain story that we started telling, and that really changed the way the course in which it was happening. So I think you were mentioning something about what is currently happening, what Apple is doing,
yes,
what are the trends that are happening right now. So would you be able to share some,
yes,
kind,
yes,
of a feedback on
in
that?
Fact, yeah. See, Apple, as everybody knows, as a iPhone, as a leader and that,
yeah.
But they are actually, they are coming up with the headset and they are coming with the like two, you know, the that displays 8K display, which is,
okay.
Yeah, which is marvelous and for the both the eyes. So they are coming,
so what you're going to come is this headset which will have a display of 8K for both the eyes.
8K resolution.
Okay.
So that way they are going to launch and I'm sure they will, I don't know what going to happen, but something going to be
so another disruption coming?
Disruption will going to come. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
great. But I think Apple and all these things is okay, you know, that's like technology and it takes time till we reach. But is there anything that is in our life, you know? Our day-to-day life.
Yeah.
How
yeah.
do I get connected?
See, do you know this there's a VR wedding happened. The first VR wedding happened in San Francisco. Into 25th May 2017.
Oh, so you are like okay. precise with that date. Brilliant.
So what happened was they actually made avatars.
Okay.
And these guys like they formally like did the wedding and all.
Mm-hmm.
And in fact, you will be knowing that now things are happening in much bigger way.
Okay.
Now in 2019, people are making VR 360 videos for the wedding.
Okay.
And now you can connect from anywhere.
Oh.
So that's the kind of things are happening now.
So that gives me an idea that, okay, my friend who is in US
yeah.
can actually kind of look at his brother's wedding, which is happening in India
sure.
in 360. Wow, that's great.
Can be done.
Yeah, but this is all okay. But what exactly is immersive? How do you actually,
okay.
it's like, Oprah, so, how do you do
me,
it?
For me, see, anything which can be engaging.
Okay.
And you get into emotions, right? See, there are already people might be talking ki, when I'm listening to music, when I'm watching movie, you get immersive. Definitely.
Correct.
But what happens when you see some animation or movie, those are very passive. Passive in the sense, they're interacting with you, but in one, you know, one direction.
So it's like I just watch whatever has been put up
yeah,
there.
Whatever put up there. Yeah. Whether I'm taking it or no, that's up to me.
Okay.
But here, when I'm talking immersive, you are actually engaging. You are also bound to be as an emotion attachment with that. Also, you are actually interacting with the there.
So like you mean are. I can push things and change
yeah,
things.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You can change. You can you know trigger something there, or you can even customize your. Whole thing, you know, customize the whole experience also.
Okay.
So when you are into VR, AR, you are able to interact with that, and that is why it is more active, and that's why it is more immersive as an experience.
So, yeah. So I could get this couple of terms, which is in VR and AR.
Right.
And
right.
I think we will go through that further.
Yeah, yeah.
But
sure.
But yes. So you are saying it is interactive, but I can't touch anything that is virtual. You know. Can if I was an hologram here, would you be able to touch me? No, you won't. But what will happen?
But there is some kind of a sense to it. You can feel that you are here.
Okay.
And there will be, you can also, we both can interact each other. Like
okay.
Some, you have something and I can do something.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not
but
saying
is
that.
It, is there somebody who's, I'm 100% sure somebody is working on something which can touch a 3D part or, okay.
Haptics is happening. There
okay.
is a, another thing happening is called mimicking the skin.
Okay.
So the human skin is now, they are making it so sensitive that now your anything which is interacting, that can work as a screen. So the human screen skin can be
mimicked.
Yeah.
So it's like even in a three-dimensional virtual space,
right.
I can touch objects.
Yeah.
So I can touch
you
this.
You feel second. It. I mean, whether you will able to actual tactile or not, but you will feel it.
You will feel it.
Feel
okay.
it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Maybe drinking water will take a bit of time.
So that is happening actually. Yeah.
Which is great. So I think this is really important that. It's becoming engaging.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're no more telling a story where you can sit, watch, and that's it, and then you kind of wind up. But it's more like you can be a part of that story. You can change it. You can watch it the way you want. I think I remembered somebody was telling me that there could be interactive movies where I can change my point of view and how it can happen. I think this is basically great. So. I think let's also look at from your experience, Shakti, that we are talking about media,
uh-huh.
we are talking about technology,
uh-huh.
but I think we need to go beyond.
Yes.
So, will it be possible for you to kind of trace the steps back in terms of the history, in terms of what exactly, how we have come to this level? We all hear this term called Industry 4.0 and things like that.
Yes,
bit heavy
yes.
for me, but I think we need to understand. Maybe you can
see,
share something.
Very popularly knows that industrial revolution. The industrial revolution first happened with the steam. So when it happened in 18th century, which is like they started the power loom,
the loom for steam.
And then the industrial revolution happened with the mass production.
Okay.
That time electricity was the revolution.
Yeah.
And afterwards, in 1969, we have a computer which is made the automation. So that is industry 3.0. And right now we are into industrial revolution 4.0, which is it's all cyberspace and it is Internet of Things.
Okay.
So we are actually interacting with the gamut of internet, and we are making, like, now you must have heard 5G, so after 4G.
Yes,
so
yes.
we are into that industrial 4.0 now, right now.
Okay.
And because of this industrial revolution and thing like that, where we have so many data, so what is eventually happening is there's it's very disruptive. The everything is data is surrounded by you, and how to manage the data, that's again it's a very crucial thing.
Yeah.
And that's how I think people are now integrating with AR, VR, and which is happening. Things, lot of things are happening.
So what is actually happening? Is it like everybody coming together? What exactly is happening when Industry 4.0 is?
Even the discipline, that's where.
Huh.
If you see right now, artificial intelligence, machine learning.
Hmm.
So those are the part of this thing, and every like right from the communication, right from the your. Industry for commerce industry, economics, everything is getting into.
So you're saying even finance is not something
finance
that is
away.
Finance also will get affected with everything, which
everything,
of course.
Everything,
okay.
everything. Yeah.
Yeah. So, so are you saying that are these all converging together, and because of the convergence, there is a important step that people have to take to make the meaning out of it,
put them
in right place.
Yeah.
Okay. So then, it's good that we need to put them in right place.
Uh-huh.
Which are these technologies that we need to put them in right place?
And the things like there are so many technologies, like even simple voice recognition, image recognition.
Yeah.
You have something like AR, VR, augmented reality, virtual reality, or mixed reality or extended reality.
Yeah.
So, what is happening now, I'll tell you. The technology is technology, right? So, we are using technology. Now, and the user is most important thing here. And how to use the technology to the user effectively, that's where the designer's roles come.
But I think the user, of course, is very important, but would you be able to briefly explain, because I can assume that a lot of students or aspiring designers or aspiring students who are here may have heard these terms, but have never understood. So,
sure.
will it be possible for you to kind of really in simple way explain what is VR, what is AR, what is XR and stuff like that.
Okay. So, VR is virtual reality, where actually the person is either they can put some headset like this. Okay.
Yeah.
And what happens is you are actually surrounded with the totally computer generated world.
Okay.
So it can be real or it can be imaginative world.
Okay.
So you are into that world and you have become part of that world.
Okay.
So that is virtual reality. Okay.
Okay.
And in that virtual reality also you can interact with that world, the terrain and the things like that, you can interact with that and you can navigate through. Okay. Right?
Yeah.
So that is virtual reality.
Okay.
Augmented reality is like augmentation. So basically, okay. I am looking at the space which is real. On that, I am adding with computer generated or some kind of a 3D elements which is virtual can be added on. So, that's why it's augmented reality.
So when you say augment, it's like being an architect and an industrial designer, it brings me back to machines and physical stuff.
Right, right.
So it's like the way machine used to augment my capacity to travel.
Right,
yeah. So
right.
I couldn't have walked kilometers, but cycles will help me cover that distance. So machine was augmenting my physical capacity.
Right, right.
So are you saying that this augmented word in augmented reality is like it's augmenting your capacity to understand meanings out of the world around you.
So
it's a real world, but it gives you
but
the meaning.
But it's added on.
Any application that you have which will help people
there are so
understand.
Many. Actually, very famous one is game actually. The Pokemon Go is, it's a very, everyone will understand that.
Okay.
So was that
Google Maps thing where there was a application where a dog, you can actually follow a dog. That's also
so
an augmented
reality. You can have pet to actually navigate you.
Okay.
So that can be done. Right?
Oh, okay. So that's an augmented reality.
That is augmented reality.
Then what is XR?
Confuses. XR or XR or mixed reality, both are same. But it is like that real environment also it becomes digital. It's like it's transmitted as a digital. Okay, the real environment. I can see the real environment. It's a basically mixed reality, which is having AR plus VR. So the world which what you see, that also become, they translated into the…
We mix the virtual and the real world together.
And what happens is you like, then it is easier to communicate from you are sitting here and somebody is sitting in California and all.
Yeah.
So, that the whole environment is like mixed reality, and you can also even now these things internet is also using, but not IoT, but internet is also amalgam of that. So it's all mixed with that.
Any examples which people might have seen or could see?
HoloLens, which is Microsoft has created a HoloLens. It's like a HMD headset. HoloLens is like you can see this live, and as well as you can see the that augmented part.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think this is very great. So we actually have a lot of technologies which are growing around us, and we should be in a position to use them. But I think I will bring that point that you mentioned earlier, that now finally people have to use it.
Yes.
Okay. And the way people actually use it. So who are the people which you feel are the right set of guys who can do it? So, you know, technology is always put to use.
Yeah.
We will use it to the best. And being an industrial designer, I could just go back and bring an analogy over here that how did industrial design start? So, they created machines which could manufacture items very fast. But that was only speed and accuracy.
Okay.
But there were set of people who were trained to get things done from these machines, which people could use. So I think if you look at the similar kind of a situation, which is what I'm understanding right now, that maybe you would need designers who can actually use this technology and tools to create meaningful things around.
Right.
So is that the kind of way in which you are looking at how this entire course will lead a person to any particular thought on that?
Yes. So basically what we, as I said before also, ki everywhere where I worked, I think the most crux of it is how you are, there's a crux of storytelling, there is narratives, right?
Yeah.
And for this, using this technology also, most of the time what I've seen, a lot of people are using now AR, VR, but after 45 seconds, they don't know what to do.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
So I find there's a gap, there's a proper gap where technology people are there, like they are actually ready to do the stuff and thing like that, but it's not reaching to the audience, target audience.
Okay.
Now what is happening with the target audience, that when you are making something with the target audience, you should also understand the user better, you should also understand how they behave, you should understand this product has to, or this whether it's a communication or whether it's a kind of a utility wise, it should be understood by them. So that's why what happens is ki you, the designers play major role where they can understand the user, they understand the space around it.
Correct.
And then the technology which is the appropriate. It can be just image recognition.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Or
yeah.
It can be just a voice recognition also.
Yeah, yeah.
So those aspects, I think designers, the better way to, they can do much better.
So the moment you mentioned voice recognition and
yes.
image recognition,
yeah.
I think most of us are carrying mobile phones in our hand.
Right.
And you would be surprised that most of the technologies that Shakti was talking about are in a certain way already available on your devices. So if you speak to Siri or Cortana, for that matter, on Microsoft, it's actually recognizing your voice. It can understand that. If it is opening the phone, the lock of the phone is opened by face, it is already recognizing your face. If there are a lot of augmented reality apps that are available on your phone, so I think all these tools are actually there in your hands in this tiny device that you have.
Right.
So it's only a matter of time that we train the people to rightly use this for the purpose.
Right,
okay,
right.
So now that's what the course should ideally do. So I think let's move to the next part where we actually now talk of the course. And here I would need you to kind of explain a lot about what the course does,
sure.
what is the duration of the course, and what is being taught and everything. So
okay.
maybe
yeah.
it will be good for you.
So in immersive media design, we are taking a very holistic way that, you know, understanding the what are the fundamentals, and then there are three things basically. So one is fundamentals, then exploration, and then applications. So in the usually it has a 4 semester. It's a master's course. It's a 2 years course, and in the 4 semester, the first semester we are covering a lot of fundamentals like principle of design, narratives, semiotics. We're talking about user, so we're talking about ethnographic research, we're talking about data visualization, we're talking about systems design, and also we are talking about coding, and you know, as a software we also talking about the Unity. So lot of fundamentals goes there. Then we come into the second semester where we are do lot of exploration, hands-on exploration. So students goes through like Unity, they go through different tools like HR, VR, and augmented reality tools. Then lot of softwares. Also, we are also doing tangible computing where they are actually working on Arduino or Raspberry Pi. They also work on different aspects of like 3D modeling. In terms of how to create a model with Blender and 3D Max and Maya. Then in that also what we do is projects. So what happens,
the projects are done in the first year itself or?
Yeah, very much year, because we have a very less time. So what we do is we've integrated the projects.
Yeah.
So the first 2 weeks, whatever they learn or the basic things, they will implement in projects.
So you learn
yeah.
and immediately apply.
Immediately apply. So that way they will learn also very fast.
Yeah.
And secondly, after the third semester, it is mostly projects. And along this side, we are also having courses like introduction relevance for AI. We have courses like history of immersive media, because one has to learn, see the how the history has evolved. We have also courses like business strategy and business management,
which is very important.
This is a new course and they will also integrate it with their own thing.
Yeah.
And then we have a projects with different things like all the applications happens.
Yeah.
And fourth semester, they are actually going for the industry. Yeah.
So they do an internship in the industry.
Yeah.
Okay. Great. So is there some way where AI gets introduced?
We do, but it's not in a very big way, but it's a relevance of AI
because into immersive. That's like the talk of town, you know.
Yeah. So it is involved. Yeah.
So what could be AI there, you know?
Right.
You would be introducing AI over there. Mm-hmm. So I think we definitely have a good course which has been packed up, which is almost about 2 years.
Right.
Goes through 4 semesters. So I was just kind of out of the context. I was just looking at this recent CES, and I saw that the Star Labs from Samsung had launched a new concept called Neon. I don't know whether you've seen it.
Yeah.
So maybe next year you don't need me to be here. A Neon can conduct this or be a part with you. Anyway, that jokes apart.
We can show some videos also.
Yeah. So what we will do is so it will be best to show the work of the students.
Right.
And before that, it would be better if you can kind of show a kind of an overview of what happens.
Sure.
And then we will go into one by one the projects.
Yeah. So this is basically compilation of the student work.
Okay. So basically, these are the projects that students have been doing. So I think that was really good to see all these projects, and I think it will be better if we kind of quickly go through few of the projects where you could explain what the students have done.
Sure.
So maybe you could, what we could do is you can start the video and we can actually talk, as we don't need the voice to run on the video. So what we have done is we have compiled few videos of the students who have done the work, and there would not be any audio onto the video, so we will speak and explain what the student has achieved or tried to attempt through the exercise.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this is, it's a again augmented reality work, and what is has been done is origami has been taught with help of AR.
Okay.
It's interestingly done, and the students will, you know, the kid will enjoy to make the paper fold according to the video, and they will also get into the technology part.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is another one.
Hmm.
It is on architecture. So it's a VR application where urban planners can make the whole permutation combination on the map, and they will also feature that what are the parameters happening, like how much open space area is covered, how much waste generation happening, and how much the things you required, car parking, amenities, and those are the things it's happening.
Yeah.
So it's a very utility based, and it's a very nice concept. I think it can be taken further also.
Yeah.
Right.
So it's basically talking about if I intervene and put a building,
right,
what is the impact on the data?
Exactly.
How much people am I adding, and it gets a live
data.
Interesting data.
Yes. And it's required a lot of coding also.
Yeah.
But nicely done. So we'll just check another one. Yeah. So another one is this is done on again Unity, and created from the actually basic model which has been taken from the transportation design, and everything has been visualized, as well as they added the material, lighting, and everything so nicely done. Created a whole like futuristic, it's a futuristic car. And the terrain has been visualized as a Mars terrain. Okay, this one is for training purpose, where one can understand the joineries of the human being, joineries, and with using very simple models, the 3D models, the joineries and all. So this is again, it's a VR project. This is for health, health domain, where one can do the physiotherapy, understanding how much the posture has to move, and it has to go. And the best part is the student has used leap motion with the gestures.
Okay.
So she has explored the gesture controls and all. This is again for the retail sector. It's again augmented reality. You can see if you take the camera towards the shoe, that pop-up happens for the
prices.
Okay, this one is very interesting one.
Now you can play the, I play the violin, you play the piano.
Okay, can you show me the piano and how to play?
Okay, I'll pause it here. I'll tell it what it is. It is on the line of music therapy and making an art therapy, right? And then again, I'll show you the another next video of the same project. So this is done by using sensors. And this is for the autism, this children which is having autism.
So there is an interaction, physical interaction that they do. They hear a sound, which is the second sense.
Right.
And they also see a color, which is the third sense.
Yes.
Which actually helps them to kind of do the correlations and coordination.
Exactly.
This is a brilliant one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's
great. So I think it's great to see all this project, Shakti, and it's really, really great work that the students have put together and under your guidance. So I think what I can see that, of course, entertainment is the place where they have taken the most of the time or use these medias. Okay. So what is happening is entertainment is taking up the most time and is the early adapter for this entire immersive media use. So what I can see is you have actually made the students to work on sectors like education, urban planning, futuristic visualization, training, healthcare, or even retail, and even the last one which I was really excited to see is the music and art therapy for autistic kids. So I think this is really mind-blowing the way it has been done, and coming from students, I think it is just going to grow as the course will flourish.
Definitely.
So I think it's really great that we are kind of putting such a course in place, and I really want to kind of go ahead, and I think there are a lot of questions that are now coming up, and we
and
need
one
to
more thing
be asking,
I want to add that my this has started just 2 years, so now my students have already gone to internships.
Okay.
So we got 100% internship.
Wow.
And there are companies like Dassault System.
Okay. Yeah.
They are French-based company.
Yeah.
Then there is a company called Xenium.
Yeah.
And Inspirit from Bombay,
Mumbai,
and there is Imaginate from Hyderabad.
Yeah.
So these are the companies, they already taken our students.
Which is great. So I think the students are also realizing, and the industry is also realizing that the
industry
students can bring value.
We are getting a good response from the industry.
Brilliant. Yeah. So I think before we get to the questions now, just spare a minute of what do students need to introspect when they think that I can join this course and I can really do something like this?
Okay. So I think foremost it is a passion.
Yeah.
The passion for, there has to be open-minded.
Yeah.
And there is a little, has to be a knack for digital. It requires both the creativity as well as the digital knack.
Okay.
And it's an amalgam. So one has to be open to that, they should ready to learn things, and they should explore.
Okay.
I think that's the most requirement.
Looking at how you are describing it, one term that comes to my mind, maybe we can coin it over here. I think we can fairly say that we want guys or students or people who are ready to do digital tinkering.
Yeah.
You know,
nice.
So tinkering is normally associated with metal and wood and all the stuff, like breaking things and joining it back.
Yeah.
And let's look at digital tinkering as a new term. If you really do digital tinkering, you are in here for the course. So I think that's great. But one thing that I always found out that the way I got connected with this course, I found out that if the students have a previous experience or inclination of getting into theater, or a bit of performing art, they've seen the kind of things, because that helps you to connect to the humanities, that helps you to connect to art and then understand the people much better. So I think that's...
As a professional background, there are students which are coming up with, like architecture background, they're coming from product design background, they're coming from fine arts background, they're coming from, also people having animation or video background also, they are coming.
Correct.
So, it is very much a kind of a mix kind of background people are coming.
So, I also understand that you also try to make sure that the background is also mixed.
Mixed.
That there is a good mix
of
peer guys,
learning.
Peer learning happens. Yeah, because a few of the projects that I have worked on previously, I have experienced this, that these kind of projects are not single person projects. You need to work as a part of a team. And there are various things in this project which one person can't do alone.
Right.
But with this course, we can expect that person knows what needs to be done, and he can play the role of a director, does in film, so he can do for these kind of immersive media things.
In fact, so, I must tell you that from internship also, I got a feedback that they are very happy to get the designer.
Okay.
Already they have worked with the, they have done the coding and all.
Correct.
The project which she is working right now,
yeah.
The project has been, they have tried with the coding and all,
yeah.
But it was not miserably failed.
Okay.
And now when she has joined, so they have realized that they need a designer so that it's required, kind of.
So you are getting the real feedback of why you want to create designers into this particular domain.
Yes.
And that's a creditable initiative that you've taken. So I think to end this, I think what we need to do is let's take some questions. I can see a lot of questions coming up. The first question is from Manish Jadhav. I'll just read out the question.
Yeah, please.
The world demands social, emotional learning and empathy from design industry today. Can immersive media support this idea of human-centered design, and how?
We were talking about this, right?
Yeah.
We were talking about how actually the...
But can you, maybe I think it will be better for that person to be given with an example, you know?
So, when we talk about like understand the human, obviously you understand like autism is a great project for
correct,
that matter.
Correct, correct.
Because the student also gone through the understanding that what is autism, how the children behaves, how is there, they look and looking at the things whether they grasp or not.
Okay. Yeah,
so
yeah.
That sound makes something interesting.
Correct.
So we have to, we are actually going into that.
Yeah. So Manish, ideally, if you saw the video which was meant, a gadget meant for autistic kids, where he is getting almost three senses, the audio, the touch, and also the visual senses, which are actually helping him to learn and understand the world around him. So I hope, Manish, that helps you, and you can even directly connect and post your questions across to Shakti on the online web.
Yes,
any further doubts that you have.
Anytime.
The next question is from Ashna. Is the role of immersive media designer realized in the industry?
Okay. So far so good. I mean, we getting the good responses from the industry. Definitely, my students are those who are gone to internship. They got a good, like as I just now said.
Yeah.
One girl, she has gone to Imaginate, and they have realized that how important is the immersive media designer.
Okay.
And they are, they are very happy to have them. And the aspect of like, I can give an example also. I believe they have created some kind of a, it's again a project where they want to create avatars and send on the VR.
Okay.
And they created some kind of a briefcase.
Yeah.
And briefcase has to be open. But the briefcase which has been made by some, I think, developer or whosoever it, artist, I believe, or somebody, that briefcase was, when it opens, it doesn't go, you don't know where it gone, or it's not opening properly.
Okay.
So, in fact, my student, she had figured out, actually, she has given them a various choice, ki how can be briefcase can be simple thing, can be done.
Okay.
So
that's an interesting
really,
yeah.
So any more question?
I think there are 2-3 more questions which actually we will definitely take up. There is a we are running short of time right now.
One more.
So is there any more question? Yeah, I think there is one more question from Akhilesh Soni. What are the barriers and benefits for immersive media startup projects designers?
Okay. So we still have to develop the ecosystem.
Okay.
Because it's a very nascent, as a even the industry for that matter, immersive media industry is also very nascent, and it is required a very established thing. So people are doing it, and for the startup, I'm sure this required a little bit more as an ecosystem, because ecosystem from the designer's point of view, ecosystem from the investor point of view, ecosystem from the technical person.
So you mean to say that the only designer is not in a position to possibly close all the loops, he will need to connect with people
that
from
is
the
happening
technology,
already
in the code, and and all those things have to be
done. So that is happening already there, I think that is the crucial point for if you understand that question.
But one question I would actually extend that question ahead, and maybe I would put that question across, that do you see that the tools like this VR headset or buying a very heavy Oculus Rift and things, are these barriers for any designer to get into this course or actually practicing further?
It's not a barrier, but like these are little heavy right now, but things are also happening in terms of hardware also. Another 2 years, things will be come up, more of like feather touch.
But does a designer need to buy this if he has to do, or there are tools that help him to simulate without using this costlier gadgets and things like that?
No, the gadget is still a little
bit
expensive. Question is there, but like AR things are going to be more happening more.
Okay.
And like I was telling ki there are a lot of things are happening into the AR and like now Apple is also looking into that AR, VR connected things. So I'm sure another 2 years you will see a lot of new gadgets, things are happening.
So what you're saying is there is a more development or possibilities that are opening up into augmented reality.
Yes.
Virtual reality is still having a bit of dependency on headsets and viewing devices.
But there are more like wire-free headsets are come, and then lesser weight headsets are.
So I think that's
also
a great.
Also, I want to add on. We are also trying to attempt one more thing. Ki our students should learn or understand, analyze how this emerging technologies will be useful for the mankind in the future.
Okay.
So there's one research-oriented one course we are having also.
Okay.
That they should also analyze.
Okay.
Because that's very necessary. And I feel that's a very
important. In which semester does this
that is take happening in the third semester.
Third semester. Yeah. So there is a research oriented course which helps them to really see it from a hypothesis perspective of what's the effect of this technology. Okay. Yeah. I think that's great. So I think what I gather from all those things that I think it's really important that the students are explained about agility, because the technology will keep changing.
Yes.
The students need to be very resourceful, because by the time he passes out and starts doing, maybe the technology has changed
and technology will come up.
Something will come up. Yeah. So I think that will have to be a part of the curriculum, and they will have to be on their toes.
They should be ready to take the challenge.
But the most important, as I gather, is you are helping students to become strategic design thinkers, which is really a great thing to happen, and I really appreciate that is happening.
They have to be innovative. Yeah. They have to be kind of, and see how can be resourcefully one can do.
Correct. So you're actually trying to create the way movies work on directors, or there are directors which are like the whole and soul and the people who run the movie. So you're kind of you're creating directors for the new immersive experiences that people will have. Yeah.
Let's see.
I think this was great to have this chat. I hope our chat has helped other people to know a bit more about what this course offers. And I think towards the end, I would really like to thank everyone who has joined, taken out time from their busy schedule, joined on this webinar. This webinar would be available as a completely recorded episode as a part of YouTube channel. You can subscribe to the YouTube channel and watch the webinar. There are links provided where you can ask questions directly to Shakti, and he will be obliged to answer them. And I think it will be really good to keep continuing these sessions. Maybe next year we should have somebody teleported into this place as a webinar. So I think let's look forward to the next session. And thanks a lot, Shakti.
Thank you, Yogesh, for having you here.
Yeah. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Abhi. Thank you.
I make the world graphical.
I add value through my products.
I am an animator.
I am a filmmaker. I develop trends.
I transform designs to reality.
I create environments.
I translate stories to furniture.
I design experiences.
I'm an immersive media designer.
I design mobility.
This is not only a design institute.
This is a design lab.
Join us in our design board.